And I would argue delta x is 2. So if we go down with here on this axis 1 down on the y direction, then we go 2 to the right. And kind of orthogonally, as we go 1 to the right here, we go 2 up. So the delta y over here is also 2. It turns out these two vectors, again, are orthogonal. If you understood what a dot product is, and you did they build the dot product of these two vectors, you would get 0, which is a measure of orthogonality. But that's not really that important. What's important is that we found out where the center of the data is, and we found the principal axis of variation. The only last thing I didn't tell you about, the only last thing is that PCA also returns an importance value, a spread value for these axes. And that spread value tends to be very large for the very first axis of variation, and much smaller for the second axis of variation if the spread is small. So this number happens to be an eigenvalue that comes out of an eigenvalue decomposition that's really implemented by PCA. But what it really gives you is an importance vector, how important to take each axis when you look at the data. So when you run the code, you'll find the new origin, you find these different vectors, and you'll find an importance value is given to these vectors that really measures the amount of spread. So let me do a little quiz here to see if we are at odds with each other.